Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to GameStar TV. We are live with the first night of Sunday Night Rocket League. We've promised you that we're going to be bringing you Sunday Night Rocket League in conjunction with the Wednesday Night Professional League Pro stuff that's been done on the CGPL channel. But here on GameStar TV 1, it's everybody else that hasn't made it through to the Pro League but is still going to play stellar Rocket League. I'm joined in the studio by two of our finest casters. We have, my name is Chrisis, firstly, and first up we've got EJ. Good evening, EJ.
Get some.
How are you doing? And running social media, the Twitch chat and all of those good things, we've got GameStar's Bizer hanging with us as well. Good evening, Bizer.
Good evening, Chrisis. Good games for tonight, man. Two crackers, I reckon.
Yeah, I'm fully expecting we're going to have some amazing stuff going on. So the first one is Corvidae versus Rovers Purple, and that is actually going to be that's the first one that we're starting, and I suspect that we're probably ready to go straight into that one.
Well, I hope so. EJ, you're set ready to go?
I don't have the lobby invite, and I'm just trying to find the details on the website because I wasn't ready for this one.
I'm going to get JCN to send you guys an invite. And then
JCN!
Can jump in.
I couldn't
That's from Corvidae. Am I saying it right? Corvidae?
Sounds yeah, I think so. So, Corvid, you know the Corvids are crows. So, I assume that Corvidae is how you pronounce it based on like the crow and something like that. Now, Corvidae, they are new to Rocket League, but I'm pretty certain they've got quite the pedigree in esports in Oceania. Don't they have one of the top CSGO teams?
I believe they do. I think it's Intermedia. I haven't looked that far into it. I'm sure your man Niba could give you a bit more insight into that, but he's not here with us right now. But yeah, they do have CSGO. I think they have a WoW team, not WoW team, League of Legends team as well. I know Rover Esports do, and they're branching out. So two esports organizations and multiple talent people. And tonight as well, Crisis, top ranked from Soma's prediction too.
Oh, top ranked. So that'll be pretty good. So our second match then that's going to be happening straight after Corvidae versus Rovers Purple is going to be Taylor's and the Swifts. Taylor and the Swifts versus Relapse. Am I right? I'm right, right?
You are right.
I think you're right. I'll let EJ cover this one. I'm just throwing you on the bus, mate. I'm sure EJ's got information on both.
No, I'm here. I'm just trying to work out details so I can invite Chrisis to the match without pressing my push to talkie and spamming him a thousand.
I've been invited, but I need a password. So, did you get given a password? Ah, okay, sweet ass. All right. I'll look it up on my computer that won't appear on stream.
That's how we do it here at GameStar.
I assume, are you putting it in Steam or Slack?
Steam.
There it is.
We've got a couple of shout-outs already. Shout-out to Papium, the manager of Rover Esports. He's looking forward to this in the stream tonight. And he hit me up before. He's like, you guys streaming? He's all stressed out. So, happy to him. And shout-out to Cookie Plates. Haven't seen you before, but hi, man. Looking forward to giving you some GameStar action tonight. Yes, your second match you're talking, Chrisis Roulette versus Taylor and the Swifts. This is CGM.
Yeah, that's YouTube's having a watch as well. Cracker Jack's having a view.
Oh, yeah. So let's keep posting this out, guys. And if one of you's got hot little fingers on Reddit, because I don't really understand Reddit yet, I've got to get myself into it. Put this stream up there and let's get people in here rolling, because you know games are just quality premium action, don't we, EJ?
They're all coming in. Roxen, Starry Feather, get some. All right, Chrisis, whenever you're ready to go, I'll tell the team to start it up. So hold it when you're ready, and I'll let them know to all join their sides and get cracking.
We're good to go, mate. No, we're not. We're not. One second, I've got one more overlay that I've got to sort out. And so who's going to be on what's
so
what
while
team?
We wait for that. Sorry, you go, mate.
Is Core going to be on blue?
To the way it works is the first team is blue, the second team is orange. So Corvidae should be on blue and the Rover Esports should be on orange. And that's the way the rules have been stated for the season, so that's how they do it. Just before we get into the game and cut me off when it starts, we do have the hashtag CGPLRL, so the Cyber Gamer Rocket League Cybergamer Pro. Oh, God, I'm stopping it up. Rocket League, just that hashtag, if you want any shout-outs, I'm looking on that tonight. So give us your shout-outs, give us your predictions and wins, everything you want, even some funny comments about EJ and Chrisis commentary if you like.
Yeah, you know what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to put it on stream. People will see me typing it, so it's not very pro. CGPLRL, but we'll get the hashtag up, and we'll put it there so that people are reminded of what they should be using. And we'll put it in the top right-hand corner. So send out your tweets, ladies and gentlemen. Hashtag CGPLRL, as you heard Biza say, for your comments or your predictions about tonight's match. And EJ, you can go ahead and tell Corvidae and Rovers Purple that they are good to go with the start. And very quietly, there they go. And we're into the first match, ladies and gentlemen. Got everything going. I think I might have had some sound repeating itself, but we should have it sorted out. And we're into the match on the blue side. Corvidae, Greeny, JCN, and X-Ross. On the orange team, EJ, we've got Anarchy Fridge, Lenny S, and Smith S.
We do indeed. So early start to the game here, fairly conventional start. Teams are going to collect boost. Others pushing for the ball. Ball coming down the right-hand side of the map now. And just got X-Cross on the map at the moment. He's spinning around, grabbing his boost. Boost control's becoming such a central part of course, Rocket League. If you can deny the opposition their boost, particularly their big boost at the edge, it really can affect the game. So we look to see if that these players... This is Amateur League, I believe, that we're in at the moment, aren't we? Yep, Amateur it is.
Yeah, so these guys have a lot to learn. This is Amateur League, yeah.
All right, huge air there by X-Cross, getting up, getting to the ball down. And he's basically racing around, so I'll go and follow some other son of a bitch. And it's Smith pushing down, ball in front of the blue goal now. This is the orange team. The Rovers are on attack, Rover Purple team. And they're dispossessed by the ball there from the boys from Corvade. And this could be the first goal. No! Smith's in there with a bit of defense, knocking the ball out. And Chrisis, they're on offense down towards the blue goal mouth.
Yeah, Greeny with a great solo effort there, but beaten by two defenders in front of the goal face there. That turns the ball around, and the ball flying across the... Well, not really flying, floating across that blue goal. It's not been cleared out, though. Another shot from Anarchy Fridge, which is a long name and quite odd. But nevertheless, he took the shots, and it was defended out there, but it's still in that blue zone. We got a demo that's cleared one defender out of the flare from Lenny S. Not good enough to confuse his opponents, and JCN picks up the halo to clear it out, EJ.
Yeah, I was on Greeny then. He was coming in for a potential shot on goal, but a nice bit of defense from the boys from Rover Purple. They're still trying to push it down now. Greeny has just dropped back onto the defense. His teammate is up with some nice air, some counter air.
Oh, danger.
This is in front of goal. This is in front of goal. There's the shot. Oh, line defense. Smith's there. Did you be happy with that bit of defense, Chrisis? Keeping the goal out.
Oh, what a great, great move there. The ball dunked down, and he picked up the savior as a result of yet another halo on defense there. So Smith's already working very, very hard in defense, keeping the donut on the board for the blue team. Well, we'll see if his good work in the back can be matched by those on offense. We saw a little bit of tete-a-tete going on there, a chase through as a demo went wanting in the end. We're sticking with Lenny S at the moment. He passes the ball down. It's carried up now, though, by Smith, who gets the cross in, and it's cleared away, EJ, by X-Ross and carried into the orange.
Yeah, it is indeed. Ball midfield now, pushing across. The Antlers doing it. Oh, this could be on. No, just a bit of height there, and the Anarchy Fridge getting up and clearing it out. So a fairly even start to the match here. 1 minute 49 left on the clock. And these are two fairly evenly skilled teams, it would appear at this stage. Both teams pushing the ball around. Some fairly even play, nice setups, but no one managing to put a goal in yet.
So we did have words earlier on that these two teams are likely to be the finalists when the season ends in the Amateur League. So not only evenly matched teams, but two of the top teams in the amateur division, EJ. And so far, really just feeling their way out. We're going to have five games to play, though, All five matches will be played tonight, ladies and gentlemen. All five games of the match, that is. It's not a best of five. It is a series of five. Cross! Oh! Yeah. And a defensive lapse there. Greeny gets the credit for it. He puts it up there. But let's have a look at what happens between these two defenders. Couple of them go up. Lenny S and Anarchy Fridge both get touches, but they juggle the ball and it goes into the back of the net. But any way you score, EJ, the blue team will take it.
Got a huge shout out to all our subscribers out there. School Bus Train in particular. We love your subscription, dude. And thank you for sticking with us. 52 seconds on the clock here. 1-0 is the scoreline in this opening game. Fast and furious action. It's what we like to see in Rocket League. The play moving up and down the field. It's pushed into the blue goal. It's a chance to get a return goal. No, X-Cross keeping it out of there. J-Cross, X-Cross, X-Cross. EJ's as blind as a bat, by the way. So if I call your name wrong, I do apologize. Likely to happen.
Oh, this is danger for the orange team. Oh. No, the shot is wide. In fact, it wasn't wide. Anarchy Fridge getting a touch to it, earning himself another halo. Let's have a look at all those saves that have been going through. One, two, six saves by the orange team. Wow. And the reality is, EJ, the percentages in favor of Corvidae at the moment because they've taken...
shot. Oh, good bit of defense.
That'll be the eighth shot that they took, and they just needed one to go in, and that's exactly what they had. One shot goes in, seven shots missed, seven shots defended by the orange team, but in the end, they needed to get some offense on as well, EJ. Perhaps they'll be able to come through for the next game, though, get themselves on the board.
And don't forget, everyone watching in our Twitch chat, we do have the regular GameStar MVP Awards running tonight, so keep track of the five rounds and who's playing well. You'll have an opportunity to vote at the end of this match before we go on to our second game tonight. Taylor and the Swifts versus someone else.
Relapse.
I was about to say prolapse, but I thought all prolapse.
No, it's not prolapse. And it's not relax either, because every time I say the word relapse, the song starts going in my mind that relax, don't do it. Of course, it's not relapse, don't do it.
And all you do when you hear that, dude, is blue steel, and you save the Prime Minister of Malaysia from being killed.
That's the one. And in fact, if you did say to a person, relapse, don't do it, you'd actually be giving them contradictory advice.
Yeah.
Because, you know...
Although if you did say, relapse, don't do it, that's probably a good bit of advice.
Maybe it's just a warning. Well, ladies and gentlemen, it is 1-0 in the series after a 1-0 victory. In that first game to Corvidae, and the question on everybody's minds is, can Rovers Purple come back, get themselves into this game, get the donut off of their board? It's going to take them at least two games to get that donut off the board, EJ, but surely they'll be able to do it in this one.
Hopefully. I'm following the saint of Rocket League. I don't know. He's just doing a bit of defense. Nice color scheme on his car. He's got that quite well pimped out.
Oh, that's down in front a roster change.
What's that?
That's a roster change. IDK coming in for... he certainly wasn't playing before.
No. He's in now. Let's see what he can do. He's wearing his halo for good luck. Ball down in the blue half now. Knocked out. Pushed down. There's a bit of defense at the back. Lenny is getting X-Cross. The height there to stop that one.
So it's X-Cross that's off and sub. IDK is on.
So, I don't know. Trying to push down here. He's staying around the middle of the field, gets a bit of air, flicks it on. If he follows this up, he's got a good chance. It's pushed to the middle. He needs a teammate backing him up. JCN was going for the boost, not ready to back him up. He manages to push it down. Here's the chance. Oh, he just misses with a flick of the
arms. Oh, the reply.
It doesn't matter because Greeny just rolls it through.
Oh, look at that. There was a shot that wasn't... it wasn't anywhere near, and you'd be forgiven if you were on defense going, what on earth were they doing? But it was obviously a set play. The power rebound into the midfield, and through came the follow-up and put the goal on the board. So that is another goal for the Corvidae players that has been unanswered. Greeny now trying to set up another one. We've got JCN on screen at the moment, but he sets it up. IDK with a second shot. And this one's defended the halo on Anarchy Fridge. Just keeping it out, EJ.
I'm staying with Lenny S because he's got the fan club going in Twitch chat at the moment. And he'll be pleased when he watches the replay. Oh, they just keep it out. They'd be stuffed if they didn't have Anarchy Fridge at the back here. He's doing a great job. Lenny S is sort of just bouncing around in the air, doing little tricks at the moment. Looks pretty good, though, but not really connecting with the ball. And maybe he doesn't want to connect with the ball. Maybe he doesn't like the ball. Maybe he just likes to do tricks in the air. Who knows? We'll find out later as the match goes on. Lenny S, ladies and gentlemen, trick jumper extraordinaire, driving in circles at the moment. Pushing out, shot on goal. That's going to be another. Who got that one?
JCN lurking and waiting for the defensive error that eventually came. Smith's tried to get the clear route, but the angle wrong on the backboard puts it right into the waiting arms of JCN. And that's 2-0. That's three unanswered goals, ladies and gentlemen, in favor of Corvidae right now.
All right, we need to get a move on from the Rovers team here. They do have the five games, as we know. And I think part of the problem could be, like, I'm following the Smiths here, and he's got a Ninja Star stuck in his car, so that can't be helpful. That's going to cause you a bad day.
Stuck through the roof into his brain. Maybe that's the issue that's going on right now. I'm sure that's...
Well, they're not PS4 players, so they have got a brain. And I don't mean that derogatory to our PS4 players, but, oh, man, they were slash quitting on me in rank today, and that was seriously bad. Here we go, though, play pushing down. This is their best chance. It's Greeny, though, blocks it out. And, in fact, we're going to get a run to the other end of the field. So the Rovers had a shot at the other end, and Greeny blocked it, followed through, followed his own ball up, and takes it to a 3-0 lead here with 2 minutes and 6 seconds to go on the clock. Don't forget, ladies and gentlemen, if you score a good goal or your team does, submit it for the Jam Gaming Top 5 Plays of the Week, because Supernova at Cybergamer is actually going to try and find us some prizes, and we'll do a ultimate top 5 at the end of the season, and the community will get to vote, and we'll have some prizes for whoever pulled off the best play of the autumn season.
Well, he has possibly one in the making as Anarchy Fridge carries it up. There's a touch there by Lenius, then a touch from Smiths, and then the ball goes looping over and there's no score. Sorry, ladies and gentlemen, I really talked it up. That's a shot from JCN. Doesn't quite make the angle though. Goes wide of the goalpost. It's sitting in the corner now. Smith's looking to get the dribble on. He's got it on his roof. He's got one player to beat. Oh, and IDK comes through and beats him on defense and gets the ball back into the blue zone. But here they come again, EJ. They're constantly picking up the ball, sending it up for themselves and taking their shots. It's wide. There's the reply of the backboard. It's cleared again. And IDK working so hard. The super sub so far, EJ, keeps the ball out of the blue goal yet again.
He does. Greeny up, intercepts the ball. 1 minute call goes out on the clock. Greeny trying to get the flick on there. Little bit of interference by the Rovers team. Stop that one. Ball hit high, coming down. Greeny's up, doesn't get the shot. Lenny's got a long range one on. It goes down towards the Corvade. I'm going to get their name wrong all night. Sorry about that, dudes, but, you know, shit happens. 40 seconds on the clock. I'm still with Greeny. He's pushing across. There's the rebound. Oh, squeezed out by Smith. Oh, I feel like some chips now after yelling out Smith's name. 30 seconds on the clock. Anyone wants to donate some Smith's chips to EJ, drop them around. Greeny getting the bounce off the undercar. Slow, though. If you hit the underside of your car or your wheels, you are going to take the momentum off your ball, as he did just then. 17 seconds on the clock. And this one is going to make it 2-0. Chrisis in favor of Corvade.
Yeah, not only 2-0 so far, it is a whitewash, ladies and gentlemen. Rovers Purple have yet to score in two games. 10 minutes of play have gone by, and they will start, they will surely be sweating in their seats right now, EJ.
I haven't got plastic on their seat, dude. They'll be sweating so hard.
They might have plastic for another reason.
Hey, yeah, my voice will do that to any day of the week. Ladies out there, right now, got the plastic down. And shout out to Starry Feathers. Starry Feathers, let us know who are those two players and who you think has the better skill out there today. And part of the issue might be, though, Chrisis, if you look at the start screen here, Curvade all have the same sort of logo, so they're sort of, you know, patented out. And for the Rovers, only one player's wearing the Rovers tag.
Well, maybe that's what it is. And you know it's not because they're PlayStation players. They don't have Cynet on their name. So no excuses, boys. You need to represent your organization. Get your tags on and get some team spirit going. Well, I'm sure that they'll get the donut off the board this time around. EJ on the orange team, Rovers Purple Eye, Anarchy Fridge, Lenny S and Smiths, and straight away Anarchy Fridge
flick
picks
on,
up.
The flick on.
Oh, so close. Anarchy Smith carrying the ball out to the midfield now after getting that halo within the first 5 seconds of the game. They've been defending well all night, EJ, and it looks like they're going to have to keep up the good work into this game.
Yeah, and the team cries are going out for Corvade now. They've definitely got a bit of a fan club in the Twitch chat. And shout out to Oza64. Tell us who you play for in COD, dude. He's known the GameStar crew since the old COD days, and that's going back a hell of a long way. Four minutes, 17 seconds.
EJ, there's a Syrix wants to know if you've ever casted with somebody called Arsenims.
Yeah, of course, possibly. Oh, once or twice in the day.
Once or twice, maybe.
Arsie and I had a race to see who would be the first in GameStar to chalk up 1,000 casts, and he beat me. I was on 999 in
JCN with the score, and goodness me, he came through, but the MVP has got to go. Oh, it was a defender on a defender knocking each other out of the way, and JCN with a great shot. The defense was there, the crossbar working together as well, but the goal in the end going through because the defenders were all sixes and sevens after butting into each other. It is 1-0 right now with 4 minutes just about of play to go, EJ. And still, Corvidae out front.
And Oza64, we have you to blame for introducing Toby to Dota. Thanks a lot from the rest of the world. 3 minutes and 33 seconds on the clock here, and the Showstorm is also here as well. It's really unprofessional to read Twitch chat when you cast in a game, but say la vie. 3 minutes and 24 seconds on the clock at the 1-0 lead in favour of Covade at the moment. Now, apparently their logos are showing up. It's a bit of a steam issue, so we'll let them off for that one. They are a uniform team here, going down hand in hand together. Oh, off the shark fin. What a save by the Anarchy Fridge. He bet he's happy he's got the shark fin gun with a save like that. Ball down into the corner now. Flicked on, pushed out, the dead zone, as Bizer likes to call it. Sort of like Bizer's bedroom on a Friday night. It's the dead zone. Lenny pushing the ball out, gets the save. Flick on. Although I've got to say, though, I did play with a Bizer this afternoon who wasn't our Bizer in a ranked game, and our Bizer is a much better Rocket League player than the Bizer I was playing with. I wish we had our Bizer.
Oh, the defensive pinch from Smith. Gets the ball away from the goal face, but it's returned, and Greeny comes through. It's wide, though. Doesn't have the angle on it. We're with Smith at the... Well, we switched away from Smith. Lenny S up on the wall. He beats one defender. Doesn't get the cross through, though. It's cleared away. And very well done by Greeny. Carried into the orange zone right now. It's a power shot. Oh, JCN. He takes advantage of the cross yet again. Not a power shot. Off the crossbar again. Look at this, EJ. Bam. Crossbar and then straight to the ground. 2-0 to Corvidae.
They're looking good here with 2 minutes and 14 seconds on the clock. And as they say, quick game's a good game. Even though they say that, Rocket League's pretty much a timed game. 5-minute rounds. Bit of overtime if we're lucky. I love a bit of overtime crisis. That sudden goal just really adds to the excitement.
Shot on goals again from Greeny. It was wide. Lenny S got a touch to it anyway. Then up against that crossbar, Greeny comes through again. He fakes JCN with a shot. It's set up now for the follow through, but the defense is there. Gets the clear out. Come on, boys from the Rovers Purple. You've proven that your defense is good, but you've got to get some points on the board to reply to the current whitewash that Corvidae is putting on. It is how many goals so far, EJ? 4, 5, 6 goals unanswered.
Be a seventh. Oh, IDK, I don't know. Just couldn't quite get up to get that one. He was very close. There's a shot. Oh, inside of the sidebar. That's the closest shot they've had all night, the Rovers boys. And not quite close enough, but almost. Nice block midfield. Smith is up there, flicks it forward. 1 minute, 6 seconds. If they get a goal here, they can well and truly push this one to overtime. Ball in the corner. Greeny's been playing well for the Covade team. Manages to push that ball out. His teammate intercepts it there. Here comes, I don't know, down the middle. But Lenny S going under the ball. As does Archetype Fridge. Everyone's going under it at the moment. They're trying to self-teabag themselves. Chrisis going that close under a ball.
Oh, all Greeny beats himself. He dribbled all the way through, beat the defender, but the lob, the pop-up was too high. Anarchy Fridge turns things around, gets his team on the board, and
That's all of a sudden. That's what you get for beating yourself.
2-1, EJ, with 32 seconds to go.
Oh, game on. Game on. They can still take this one 3-2. The comeback train will be departing the station if they can get another goal in this 30 seconds to take this to overtime. It's pushed down towards the orange half of the field, the Rovers side. Two players up right into the corner, hits a sidebar, doesn't go in. I don't know, he's back on defense, just staying here. And the ball is pushed out. He's got one player in front of him. That's Smith. He intercepts that. Great timing. Keeps it into their quarter. All three players back for the Rovers. 9 seconds on the clock. They need a miracle, an absolute miracle. It's in front of goal. Oh, Greeny stops the miracle. 3 seconds on the clock, and that's going to be it. Ball bounces. Time up. And we are now 3-0 in favor of the Corvidae team. Corvidae. I will get their name right by the end of the cast. Highly unlikely.
Just call them the Crows.
The Crows, yes. Throw in the Crows.
EJ, you say it slow. It's Corvidae.
Corvidae? Who's that? Sounds like a pasta dish you want to eat.
Is that not what it is?
It is Corvidae. No, Bison, you've got it right. And the fact that you've got it right, mate, says EJ's got no excuse. We call them the Crows, though. That is what their symbol is.
I don't need an excuse.
I think the Crows... The Crows are just one of the Corvids, though. I think Ravens are Corvids as well. So you could call them the Ravens if you wanted to. Yeah, I'm walking out the science, and I need a quick save replay and then ready.
The two teams are just working out that they had to play the five games there. The team that lost 3-0 were about to leave.
And good thing they did it. So just a reminder, ladies and gentlemen, if you are playing in the CGPL, whatever division it is, it's a five-game series, not a best of five. So you play out all five games.
And all points count.
Yeah, even if you've lost 3-0, you can still win two games and improve your statistics overall for the season. So you got to play them all out and play them as if they all count, because they all do.
Just quickly, Chrisis, let's get that hashtag going in Twitter, guys. If you have a Twitter account, hashtag CGPLRL, with your comments, predictions, shout-outs, whatever you want to put in there. At the moment, it's empty with all my stuff.
Oh, this time!
JCN, what a beautiful... That's a Jam Gaming Top 5 Player of the Week if you ever saw it. Watch this, Chrisis. He catches it in the antlers and just dribbles it down on his bonnet, bumps it over the player who was defending and into the back of the goal. And Flip would be happy with that one.
Hashtag CGPLRL, as Biza was saying, and you could have put a hashtag juggler onto that one.
Hashtag antlers. 4 minutes, 20 seconds on the clock. Oh, I thought we were going to get a second then, but beautiful Anarchy Fridge defense. And apparently Corvidae or Corvidae means raven, and they are the Corvidae Ravens.
Oh,
thanks
okay.
Thanks to JP Poonage.
Right. Oh, shout out to JP Poonage then, who is playing for Abyss Esports, who for a while has actually been a team to watch in the CGPL.
By the way, you said that, Chrisis, for a while they're a team to watch?
Yeah, because of course last week we had a massive upset, and now I've changed my mind. The team to watch is hashtag enemy territory, otherwise known as the All-Stars.
Well, they knocked off Sequential.
Yeah, they did, indeed.
Yeah,
they did.
Yeah.
Knocked off, not knocked up, so... Sequential have a chance to come back without any sort of encumbrances to keep them down. 1-0 right now at the moment in favor of Corvidae in the fourth game of the series. They are 3-0 up in the series. And right now the boys from Rovers Purple looking to restore some pride, get some stats on the board, and look for some positives out of the next two games to take into next week's match.
And it will be interesting Wednesday night, everyone. Don't forget to tune in as Rovers have tied up the scores here.
Beautiful setup. Smith puts it up. The bounce and then off the backboard. Just beats the defenders in terms of their angle prediction. And Anarchy Fridge, well, he had it right down pat and powers it into the net. 3 minutes to go. 1-1. and maybe they are going to be able to spark a little bit of a resurgence, EJ.
I think so.
I certainly hope so.
I was going to say, before I hocked up a lung oyster that would have curled the hair on an aunt, is tune in Wednesday night to see how Sequential are going to rebound after their first recorded loss in a major tournament.
Yeah, well, we'll be there, hopefully. I mean, I don't know. We get told on a week-to-week basis who exactly is going to be casting. But, man, that is a week of an evening's worth of Rocket League that, whether I'm casting or not, I'm not going to be missing. Hashtag CGPLRL. We'll be tweeting about that all day.
Oh, shots on goal. Defended out nicely there by the boys from Rover Purple. There's the flick, hits the crossbar, there's the follow-up, and Greeny gets the second goal for the boys from the Raven team with 2 minutes and 8 seconds on the clock. So there's the setup by JCN and the follow-up by Greeny knocking it into the back of the net there.
Total opportunism there. Greeny picked up a boost in the corner and charged into the midfield there. Two defenders passed the ball. And Greeny was there to say, well, if you're going to leave it, I'm going to smack it into the goal. 2-1 with 2 minutes of play to go. We're still with Greeny. He's the goal scorer. He sets it up, but it's defended and cleared away into the midfield. Who's up in the air? JCN gets a touch to it. IDK follows through and off the crossbar gets a score. And IDK, his full name is I don't know what to say. Which we'll forgive him for not having that, because I don't think you can have a Steam name that long, EJ.
No, Don Mega struggles to fit his name in, so that guy's got no chance. The Raven boys in control here over the Rovers boys. Ball across in front of goal. Oh, defensive lapse there. If they had a player following through, they had a great chance. Pressure still on. Greeny trying to do it all himself. Sets it up. Here comes the goal. No, it's the fridge. He's at the back there, blocking it out, as he's done all night. The scoreline would be far worse, crisis, if they didn't have Fridge at the back.
Yeah, and in fact, Fridge at the front, because he's the only goal scorer in this game. 3-1 with a minute and 15 to play. There have been comebacks that have been tighter than this, and that's the way to do it. Get the ball up into the blue field. That's exactly what Anarchy Fridge has done. He's looking for the follow-through. He gets a touch off the defender, but IDK is there with the cover defense. Clears the ball away, and it's into the orange zone now. He's carrying it over, sets it. Oh, what? That is a Jam Gaming top five play if I ever saw one. The pinch from IDK together with Greeny, and that's what creates that goal. 54 seconds to go, 4-1. Greeny gets the credit for that, EJ, but goodness me, what a group effort that was.
Yes, we love a bit of group effort here in Rocket League, and it really does depend on it. There's a lot of individual skill, but in three-on-three, it's the setups and the follow-up. You've got to follow the ball up, particularly long-range shots. You knock a ball downtown, you follow it up. Chances are it's going to rebound out and set it up for a goal for you. 37 seconds are on the clock here, and it looks like this is going to be another goal. It is JCN. They've just pulled a wound open here, and they're pouring a whole bucket of salt in, and I think the Rovers might actually be enjoying that.
Oh, lovely piece of flair there from the Reindeer Man. Greeny, of course, with a great little dribble. They must have been practicing this. It's like a skill throughout the team that they have, where they put it onto the roof, do the dribble across, and then do the little pop-up. And it wasn't working for them earlier on. No, the shots are wide. It's still there, though. Two, three players. No, it's cleared out. And Smith...
Greeny was actually defending for the Rovers then, just to help him out.
Yeah, as I was saying, they've been dribbling all night, but mostly trying to complete solo efforts. And as soon as they started using their dribble to set up pops to their teammates, that's when they've been opening up the real scoring. I mean, we had very, very low scoring earlier on, EJ. 1-0, 3-0, 2-1. And this game now comes through Corvidae. Really dominating with a 5-1 victory.
Very, very dominant. We're going to go into the fifth and final round here. MVP will be voted for after this one, so look to see who you might be nominating for this one. And I've got to say, Chrisis, I'm actually tempted to come down to the CGPL land final now just to see the school bus do his stripper routine on a pole.
Is that what he said he's going to do?
No, but I'd like to see it still.
You have me there. Why is he going to do it?
Because he reckons it's going to happen, and I can't wait to see it. And apparently you only get into Soma's after party if you actually play on a controller, and there's currently a fundraising going on for Groovy Grape's controller, so get some.
What, Groovy Grape doesn't have a controller?
If Groovy Grape plays on a keyboard, he is an absolute king among men.
There's no way.
Apparently there's a reason why he can't, because his computer doesn't allow to configure the controller to his computer, so he has to play with the keyboard.
Time to get a new computer. 4 minutes, 41 seconds on the clock here in the fifth round. It's 4-0 at the moment in favour of the Raven team, which is much easier for me to say than their actual name. And JCN here, I don't know, it actually is, flips it to the centre of the field. Lenny pushes it out. Lenny's been quite quiet. I'll go over and inspect Lenny for a little bit, see what Lenny can do. Oh, Lenny's airborne there. Nice little airborne play by Lenny, getting the underside of the car onto the ball. He's hanging around the midfield here, getting great intercept. Lenny with the centre. He just needs some backup. The ball rebounds out. Here comes his teammate, knocked up across the middle of goal. Lenny's up. Lenny hits it. No goal.
Yeah, they're trying to put things together, but the players, oh, as I say, the players are out of position. And for the first time in the evening, ladies and gentlemen, Anarchy Fridge gets his team onto the board and in the lead.
That's a pretty good goal, actually. Well done.
Yes.
Nice shot.
Great setup, great creation, a bit of frenetic activity to start off with, and then somebody to punch it home and put the point on the board. 4 minutes of play to go, though. We're back in the blue zone, and Corvidae might have gone to sleep just a little bit. The goal bouncing past the face of goal. No defender really gets a touch to it, but fortunately for them, there was nobody from the orange team ready to take advantage of themselves. Now the pinch off the back screen. Lenny's going to pick it up in the in the air. Doesn't quite touch it. Smiths has to come through and take it through. We got Anarchy Fridge at the moment. He keeps scoring for his team. He's having to lurk around though, EJ, and get four back though, because things aren't happening. No, he's coming forward again. He's looking to set it up, but JCN with a good touch eases the pressure.
And shout out to Rovers Smiths for the bastard play of the day. His teammate was about to pick up the big boost and he nudged him out of the way and took it. That's gold, absolute gold. Ball in front of the gold mouth now of the orange team. The Rovers team's flicked out down halfway into the field. Centering ball coming in. Smith's backing in. Nice bit of block work there by Smith. Sets it up. The Fridge gets a second shot on. Smith's still here in the middle of the field. This is the second chance they've had. They need a good centering ball. They haven't got it. They might have balls in the net.
Lenny!
Rovers!
Lenny with
the Lenny's fan club are going to go nuts. Crisis in Twitch on that one.
Oh, that was just great play. Lenny with the juggle between defender, the post, and his top hat puts the second one on the board for Rovers Purple. And he'll be pleased with that, if not with the total result of the game.
Well, he'll be pleased with his own performance. He's helped the team get a couple of goals late in the half. There's another one. Oh, what great defense. That's Didge-level defense right there, ladies and gentlemen, by, I don't know, keeping the team down to still on the donut, though, but keeping them out of a 3-0 lead. I'm still with Smiths here. He's putting the pressure on. Ninja Star or not, he'll be damned if he's going to go down without a fight. And this is a great chance here if they can get a centre ball, but I don't know, pushes it out, saves it. Ball pushed forward, Smiths clearing it on. No, always stuck in the corner. It's terrible crisis when the ball gets stuck in the corner.
Well,
I can
that's...
hear my parrot on the stream, can you? I've got headphones on, I can't hear her.
Yeah,
but shout out if my parrot's having a rip.
He's there, but everybody, I think, has just assumed they've got that new aerial topper. So somebody on the field must have it. That's why there's a parrot going on. As the ball gets into the blue zone again, this is the Rovers looking to get some consolation stats onto the board. There's the dribble, there's the follow through, but JCN actually gets a double touch to it, needs to hook up with Lenny and get some lessons on how to juggle and score as opposed to juggle and do the defense for the team, for the opposing team instead of get the score in. It's still sitting in the orange zone. The donut's still on the board, but it's cleared out. Nice pinch there. Anarchy Fridge with a shot on goals, but well defended by JCN and EJ. A minute to go. And why did Rovers not play like this in the previous games?
Well, I think it's just taking them this long to warm up. There's a shot on goal, flicked out. Greeny with a good bit of defense there. Ball just bouncing around the middle of the field. No one going for it. Under a minute on the clock here. And Rovers, this is all Rovers this round. Constant pressure on the Raven goal. Nice intercept in the middle of the field by Lenny S. There stops the attack into the Rover purple half of the field. But it is down there now. It's coming across. Strong chance for them to get a goal on. Greeny misses it. And that allows Lenny to flick it out with 30 seconds on the clock. JCN comes across. Lenny with the shot. Gets it up. Who's following through? No one's following through. No goal.
20 seconds to go, and it's into the blue zone. A little bit of pride at stake here for the Corvidae, who have been held out with the donuts for this fifth and final game in the series. I don't think they're going to be able to pull it back. 5 seconds to go. This is a chance. Their last chance, in fact. JCN sets it up. Up into the air goes Greeny. And, oh, they get a little bit of pride back. Keep the donut off the board. JCN with a great touch. Lobs it over into the center. And Greeny restores their pride. 2-1 in the end in that last game, EJ, for the Rovers.
Now, I actually personally think Greeny was probably the best player on the field there. He's my tip for MVP. But people in Twitch chat, who do you think warrants an MVP nomination out of that match tonight? Let us know in the Twitch chat, and we'll no doubt add them. Now, it's a combined MVP tonight, so whoever gets nominated from tonight will be added to whoever's nominated in the next match, and then you vote, and they win the $20 Steam card, courtesy of GameStar.
Yeah, so we got a lot of votes coming through from for Greeny at this stage. So I guess they were looking to...
it's all the stoners out there voting for the Green. Shout out, boys.
And we did have a question from Grand Illusion about the name of your parrot.
While we're my parrot's name is Oscar, named after Oscar Langley Soy Roo from Neon Genesis Evangelion. To any of the good anime fans out there, will understand who Oscar Langley Soy Roo is, and that's the name of my parrot. And she rocks. But she's old and cranky now. That's the only bad thing about her. Kind of like me.
You're not cranky.
Well, I can be, trust me.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, I think oh, you spell Oscar A-U-S-K-A, I think. You don't spell it O-S-C-A-R.
No, it's spelled same as Evangelion, Oscar. A-S-U-K-A, Asuka.
Asuka.
And shout out to my mum, who just reminded me to put my phone on silent as she's texting me about I'm a celebrity, get me out of here. Go, mum.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, that is a shoe. Well, Greeny is a shoe in then. So, Greeny, make sure that you add me on Steam. And once you've added me on Steam, or in fact, you could even just go to GameStar.com/contact and send me your details. I need your real name and your address. And we will be sending that $20 Steam card your direction if you are the winner of tonight's votes. Bear in mind, of course, Greeny goes into the hat together with whoever the MVP is from the next game, EJ. And that is probably a good time for us to end off this particular game. We're going to go to a short break, ladies and gentlemen. Don't worry, we're not going to play adverts at you because GameStar doesn't play adverts. I think you get an advert when you first join the stream. So sorry for that. It's something that happens when you get partnered.
We apologize. Feel free to run ad block.
So we won't play any adverts. We'll just get some tunes on for you while we get ourselves ready for the next game. And that game is, I'm sure, going to deliver good results for your viewing pleasure, just as today, this previous one did. It is going to be Taylor and the Swifts going up against Relapse. So stay tuned. We'll be right back.